bagay ba yung pink? Tara, punta tayo dyan sa labas. Meron akong ipapakita sa inyo sa penthouse ng villa na to. Subscribe na kayo. Ito 100% free. Mamaya malalaman nyo kung bakit ipapakita ko sa inyo yung view dito sa penthouse ng villa. Pero ngayon, punta na agad tayo sa effects of color. I'll break this into 4 parts. Number 1, categories of color. Number 2, psychological effects of color. Number 3, the complementary colors. And number 4, energy impact of colors. The 3 categories I made has something to do with temperature. Mahahati sa 2 category ang color wheel. First is warm feeling, from yellow to red on the right side. And the second is cool feeling, from green to purple on the left side. Third is neutral color, na wala sa color wheel. Dahil ito yung shades, lightness and darkness of color, like black and white. Warm colors gives you a feeling of warmth due to their brightness, and parehas ito sa color ng fire or sun. They convey optimism, enthusiasm, and passion. Maganda rin ito sa cold climate to give a sense of balance on temperature. Cool colors. Cool colors are cool because these colors are also found in nature, like the blue sky, green leaves, and water. Cool colors are known for their calming effect, relaxing, and subdued. Maganda naman ito sa warm climate to give you a feeling of coolness and relief sa init ng temperature. Neutral colors. This includes black, white, brown and gray. These are earth tones and gives an impression of power and pureness. Gawa naman tayo ngayon ng perspective ng bahay para meron tayong kukulayan to visualize the colors. Simulan na natin ang pagpintura. Red. Red is the most vibrant color, expressing excitement, passion and sexuality, power, joy, speed and danger. Building na gumagamit nito, for example, is fast foods and motels. So now you know the reason, huh? In China, if I may add, red is regarded as the color of happiness, well-being, and good fortune. This is also a good thing to know dahil marami ka makikita business establishments na red ang primary colors. Blue. Blue is a symbol of loyalty and trustworthiness, faith since the ancient times, business and nature, restful, calming, and tranquil. That's why it lowers blood pressure temporarily. Blue can also be depressing. Navy blue. It commands respect, representing loyalty, trustworthiness, and dignity. Kaya madalas mo ito makita sa mga corporate logos. And isama mo na rin yung navy blue men's coat business attire. That is why this commands an instant respect pag suot mo. Yellow. Psychologically, yellow is the happiest color. It has warmth, optimism and joy. It lifts spirit, lifts self-esteem, and a color of confidence and optimism. Orange. Orange is stimulating and energizing. It appears friendly, outgoing, cheerful, and adventurous. Since it is a combination of red and yellow, it has both characteristics of energy and happiness. Bright orange has a very contrasty visibility, kaya ginagamit ito sa mga warning signs. Nakakagana daw ito ng appetite, kaya maganda ilagay sa dining space. Green. Green is the most relaxing and calming color. The color of nature, restful and refreshing. It has healing powers as the color of nature. This is used in hospitals' operating rooms to sedate worried patients and visitors. It is also used in hospital sheets. Green is also a symbol of environmental stewardship and responsibility, at yan din ang dahilan kung bakit pinili ko ang green sa logo ng channel na ito, dahil I'm talking about human shelter and the environment. Purple. Purple is well known associated with royalty. It influences sophistication, wealth, and privilege. It is a very powerful color even in small amounts. Kaya pala mukhang luxurious tingnan yung Cadbury na chocolate. Pink. Pink is a symbol of youth, good health, feminine, sentimental, romantic, exciting, and cheerful. Just like red, as it came from the very light shade of red. At yan ang suot ko ngayon. Pink. Brown. Brown is an organic color. Wholesome, simple, and honest. Similar to green, this is also an earth color. Brown is mostly seen in natural wooden materials. Brown is very cozy and can be considered as neutral color, as it can be paired with almost any color, just like the beige color, which is a very 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 light shade of brown. Black. Black is a color with a very special presence in architecture. This color is also to be taken seriously. It represents power and control, luxury, sophistication, and exclusivity. It is also a symbol of death, evil, and mystery. Too much black may create adverse environment. Maganda itong black kung gusto mong i-accentuate yung power and presence. But it should be used strategically and with a combination of other color or other shades. White. White symbolizes purity, innocence, goodness, and truth. White is widely used in architecture because of its purity of form, function, cleanliness, and simplicity. Since white is a neutral color, you can pair any colors as you want for a building accent. White is also very energy efficient, and we'll get to that a little later in this video. So magaganda naman ang meaning ng effects of color. Kaya sa pagpili ng color, gamitin mo lang yung intuition mo or kung ano man yung favorite color mo. Tapos, with your understanding of the effects of color, makakapili ka kung ano yung message na gusto mong i-project. So yan ang mga basic primary and secondary colors. Other colors naman is combination na lang ng primary and secondary with different shading intensity. Combination of these colors will give you effects of openness and diversity. Ang complementary color ay color na pag ipapartner mo to another color ay mas lalong ma-enhance yung kulay nila together dahil they are high contrast with each other. Madali lang yan malaman. Mag-search ka sa Google in your phone or computer ng color wheel. Okay, kunin natin itong isang to as an example. Yung opposite ng color on one side on this wheel is yun ang complementary color niya. Let's say, blue paired with orange on the opposite side will enhance each other's color, and red naman pag ipapartner mo sa green na nasa opposite side ay ma-enhance yung color combination nila together. And so on with other colors. Understanding this will help you choose an accent color to add in your color scheme. Pagmasdan nyo ngayon yung complementary colors na ginawa kong accent sa window and entrance to give you an idea how it works. Kaya palang sarap tingnan ng ube with cheese combination. Bagay na bagay. Pansinin nyo ang kulay ng paligid. Ang kulay ng mga bahay at katabing buildings, mostly puti, beige, light mocha brown, very light brown, ang makikita nyo. By afar, parang lahat sila ay beige or kulay ng desert. There is a reason to that and I will explain you why. Dito sa Qatar, extreme ang temperature during the summer at talaga namang hindi mo ito mai-ignore. Ang mga bahay dito ay ini-encourage na gumamit ng light colors and earth tone colors as the natural surroundings for a very good logical reason aside sa native architecture nila ito and cultural reason. Ang mga light colors kasi does not absorb as much heat as dark colors. May mga bagong developments din dito na nag-i-implement ng green building principle design. At isa dito ay yung pagpili ng kulay na hindi nag-a-absorb ng sobrang heat, not only to reduce energy cost, but to give a cooler effect. Only a certain percentage of dark color is allowed for design accent and contrast purposes in some of the developments here. Meron din tayong Philippine Green Building Code at titingnan natin yung section sa performance ng color sa metal roof surfaces in a while. Ang mga light earth colors naman ay may advantage dahil kakulay nito ang desert and earth tone color dito sa Qatar. Hindi ito nakakadumi sa paint ng mga bahay pag may desert storm and occasional rains. Napapanatili nila na maganda at malinis ang urban landscape, which is napakaganda. Itong table na pinapakita ko ay galing sa Philippine Green Building Code from the DPWH website. Sabi sa section na ito, metal roof surfaces shall either be colored white or have a minimum SRI, solar reflectance index of 70. Kung titingnan mo yung performance ng white, the SRI is 80, which is more than the minimum, and that is good. At yung dark gray naman ay SRI 0 to 41. That is below the minimum. So napakalaki ng difference. Please check the link in the description below if you want to know more about this. My recommendation for a more energy efficient design is gumamit tayo ng mga light colors para sa majority part ng mga walls. And ilimit naman natin yung mga dark colors sa accent pieces para sa gusto mong design theme. Tapos, let's take advantage of the natural earth tones, natural materials, and texture. Okay, I'll give you a bonus tip. Kung hindi mo alam kung paano ka magsisimula sa pagpili ng color, mag-search ka sa Google ng mga sample buildings para makakuha ka ng inspiration. Tapos, gamitin mo yung knowledge mo sa effects of color para makapag-decide ka dun sa meaning na gusto mong i-represent nung building. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you do like my work, please like and subscribe to this channel. I'm also inviting you to please check all the videos on this channel. And promise, it will not waste your time.